Life is a time pass, का फर्क पड़ता है, कोई दिक्कत नहीं पता नहीं, जो थारी राय सो मारी राय, nothing to do no where to go, देखो सुनो मत बोलो. कुछ पाना ना कुछ खोना, who asked you, even zero come in heaven, आज भी रहो ही हैप्पी. श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा. गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः. तस्मै श्री स्पिरिचुअल जर्नी एंड रिलीजियस लाइफ दीज आर टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स. इन रिलीजियस लाइफ we normally lead the religious life for two purposes. One is fulfillment of our desires. Okay. When we go to any temple before any god, there is a big list. Do this, do this, do this, do this. So, our life and attainments of prosperity is the goal, and God is the means. It should be the other way around. Our life is the means, and attainment, oneness with the God, is the goal. This is called as the sadhana sadhya vivek. Sadhana is means. Sadhya is the goal. So what is the goal of our life? Our goal is to get happiness. There is no other goal. Because whatever we do or we do not do, it is only for getting happiness. This is the fundamental of spiritual life. So what we know, religious life. So that we get happiness in life and we fail. The first step to graduate from the religious life to the spiritual life is we stop seeking happiness in life. Then we start discovering happiness in our life. What is the difference between seeking and discovering? Seeking is which is not now, but afterwards, if when I do these things, then I will get happiness. See? So the young, healthy, educated and free boy thinks, if I get married, I will be happy. So what is he doing? He is seeking happiness. So when you seek happiness, what exactly it means? You have already declared the bankruptcy of your miseries. You are miserable. Therefore, you are seeking happiness. Why do we seek food? Because we are hungry. Why we seek water? Because we are thirsty. Why we seek happiness? Because we are miserable. So our whole life is only seeking happiness. We have to stop that. The the first step on the spiritual path. GPS. Where are we? Point of origin. What is the destination? See? So, point of origin is seeking happiness. Stop that. Now start your journey. And it can be done only by one simple way. Pariksha lokan karmachitan brahmanaha nirvedamayat na asti akrutaha krutena tad vidnanartham guru meva vigachet samit panihi shrotriyam brahmanishtham. Take a pause and look behind. What have we achieved and attained in life? If we discover we have attained fulfillment, you are done with. If there are still some loose ends to be tied down, then we have to go the journey further. Then how do we know that we have lived a religious life? Tulsidasji says in simple words, dharmate birati jogate jnana jnana moccha prada veda vakhana. If we are leading religious life, the net result is dispassion. If the dispassion doesn't kindle in our life, then we were cheating ourselves under the disguise of being a religious person. See, friends. Therefore, what is the spiritual life then? So we stop seeking happiness and we start discovering happiness. And it can be done only. See, discovery is done by understanding, intelligence. See, like the common example, like so many times the apple have fallen on the floor or from the tree. See, if I were along with Newton and both of us have seen the apple falling down, what I would have done? Take the apple and rub it and eat. Because when I eat apple, I'll be happy. But he didn't do that. Event is the same. He started discovery. See? Why this apple has gone down? Why not up? Exactly the same way. When we get something that we were seeking, what exactly happens? Seeking is a disturbed mind. And when we get whatever we want, the disturbances of the mind are quietened. Therefore, quiet mind is the beginning of discovery of happiness. See? So we must have a proper GPS. See? So GPS is given in our Kathopanishad. And before that, the teacher told up to the 9th mantra that our 5 objects are the paths on which the 5 sense organs, the horses are running. They are controlled by the reins of the mind and the reins are in the hand of the intelligence. And then life is lived under the influence of intelligence or whims and fancy. If we are leading our life intelligently, not intellectually, intellectuals are intelligently miserable. Intelligent people are never miserable. So if we are leading our life intelligently, then alone we will be able to discover happiness. So when we discovery, what does it mean? Suppose this flower is here and something is on this one. And I am searching for the flower. Hey, where is that? Where is that? I don't have to create. simply remove the cover, the thing which is already existing is discovered. So self-discovery, we don't have to create happiness in life, discover happiness. See? So we have to start our journey with the help of this GPS. Therefore, spiritual journey is not in time and space. Suppose you go from here to Andheri. You put the GPS. Then, what is the ETA? ETA is 2022. This much time will be required, and there will be traffic, red line or brown line. It could be anything. So this much time will be required. Now this journey, spiritual journey, is not in time, not in space. But it is a journey. Now to understand this, take your day-to-day example. How much time and energy and efforts will be required for the husband to be a man? That is all. And yet, the husbands continue to be non-smiling. You know the meaning of husband? Those who are hasi is band, is husband. Now here some husbands are laughing because they are here. Ghar mein haske dikhao. So what is the journey? This is the journey. Find out where you are and what is the destination. So you are the traveler, you are the journey, you are the destination. Kabirji's one bhajan is very good. Aap hi mali, aap bagicha, aap hi kaliya todane wala. Aap hi mali, you are the creator. You created a husband. Nobody created. Aap hi mali, aap bagicha. Samsar or aap kaliya todane wala, you are the same constantly. Oh Maharaj, discover this truth, and for that we must have a perfect GPS, and this GPS is told in the 10th mantra. इंद्रियेभ्य परायर्था अर्थेभ्यश्च परम मनः मनसस्तु परा बुद्धिः बुद्धेरात्मा महान् परः महतः परम अव्यक्तम् अव्यक्तात् पुरुषः परः पुरुषान्न परम किंचित सा काष्ठा सा परागति. So the point of origin and destination is indicated by this GPS. First, where are we lost in this world? We are all the victims of our sense organs. Simple, friends, not difficult. The first thing we have to, like, you know, Bhagwan tells Arjun in reply to his question, why we go the wrong way? The teacher says, kamayesha krodayesha, because desire and anger. What are they? Vidhi enam iha vairinam, they are our enemies, desire and anger. Okay, what should be done with the enemy? Kill. No forgiveness for the enemy. He should be killed. If you don't kill him, he will repeat it again. See, friends, This desire is like a gangrene on the mind. See? So, should be killed. Vidya ilam iha vairinam. Then how do we kill that? You must know where is the hideout. So the hideout is indriyani mano buddhi asya adhishtanam uchyate etair vimohayate shaha jnanam avrutya dehinam. So this desire virus is functioning from the platform of sense organs. After the sense organs are conquered, then it goes deeper. It comes at the level of the mind. We become emotional if we don't get our desires fulfilled. In this house, I am the most unwanted person. All Buddha, the same thing. And after this mind is conquered, it goes in the intellect. There were a few relations of a rich man, and he has written his will, not to be opened in front of the lawyer in the court. So everybody was waiting, now what is coming to me, what is coming to me, what is coming to me. They're all anxious, and the time came and they opened the will, and it is said, I believe in reincarnation. Therefore, I pass on all my property to myself only. All the remaining people also died. Friends. So first, sense organs are conquered, then the mind, then the intellect. So where from to begin? Begin from the sense organs. Now out of the sense organs, 10 of them, 5 plus 5, 5 karmendriya. So hold only one, and that is the tongue. Because tongue is 2-in-1, tasting as well as talking. See? So for that, what should be the journey on this spiritual path? Dekho suno mat bolo. You have conquered karmendriya. And how we conquer karmendriya? Because when we receive something through our sense organs, eyes for example, or smell, or taste, we receive this knowledge and then we react. So when we react, then the reaction is through the speech and experience is through the sense organs. So these two are to be controlled. Therefore, whatever experiences come in our life, we make it a point very clearly. No more comment on anything in this world. See, my friend, the highest spiritual practice I am telling you, I am not taking you to any meditation and all kinds of difficult, complicated Shankaracharya's bhashya. That is enough for those who are getting lost in ghatakash, matakash, patakash. See, don't get lost in that. You don't have to go and give lectures anywhere. You have to protect yourself from yourself. See, it's not difficult. So if we take this simple thing, dekho suno mat bolo, your mind will remain at peace. Therefore, indriyebhya parayartha. Now, what are the sense organs? Sense organs are the expression of the tanmatra of the five elements. So, tanmatras are the cause and the respective sense organs are the effect. So, when the effects are controlled, you reach the cause. Okay. So you come to the tanmatra. Now, what is the meaning of this? Be very attentive. The tanmatra of the fire is rupa. And the objects are different shapes and forms. Now our vision is not influenced by any color and form. So what will be the spiritual practice? Dekho with the eyes. Suno with the ears. Mat bolo, What has happened? We have started from the objective world and we have come to the source, the tanmatras. कोई निंदो कोई वंदो कोई कैसे कहो रे राम सांगे प्रीत बांधी होत जैसे होत रहे. देखो महाराज, we are doing nothing. Real spiritual practice is undoing and unbecoming. So indriyebhya parayartha, so we have come to the tanmatras, and then arthebhyascha param manaha. So beyond the tanmatras is the mind. Mind only expresses as the sense organs and organs of action. See? So the five sense organs are specific to a particular object, shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha. Now mind doesn't have any of these qualities, any of these attributes. Mind doesn't have the shape, it doesn't have the touch, it doesn't have the form, it doesn't have the taste, it doesn't have the smell. Therefore, all these sense organs become important and we come back to the mind. Then, when this mind comes in contact with the world, it starts reacting. Because of default, that is our habit. We have to talk. We have to give comments. And then, as if the mind falls, where? In the sense organs. After falling in the sense organs, further fall in the worldly objects. So go back. So, indrebhya parayartha, arthebhyascha param manaha. We have come to the mind. Now what is the mind? Mind is the seat of likes and dislikes. See? And the best part is, likes and dislikes have no logic, no reason. No logic, no reason. But our whole life is guided by likes and dislikes. So if we have to continue our spiritual journey, what should be the step? We have to go beyond the mind. Going beyond the mind means what? Living at zero complaint level. No complaints. See? On the first day when we came, arrangements were not there. Now, how do you take that event? Should we become angry? Should we become frustrated? Or we should have the wisdom. And what is the wisdom? What right we have got on anybody in this world? We have no right on anybody. Recognize this. See, at two stages we suffer in our life. First, with reference to the things. We want the things. Desire for the worldly things. And with the relations, expectations. If we remove the desire for the worldly things and expectation from anybody in the universe, you are one with the divine. And for that, living at zero complaint level, what right we have got on anybody in this world? Now this beautiful place we are getting it, our Girish Bhai, he is doing all that. Now what right I have got on him? No right. And once we recognize this, you can never be arrogant in life. Why arrogance comes? We start thinking, konyosti sadrusho maya, I am the best one. Therefore, try this. Give up your right, right away, before they perform your rights right now. See, friends, this is so simple, my friends, not difficult. Therefore, from the mind we rise, and then we come to the intellect. So mind is the seat of likes and dislikes, expectations. Then we come to manasastu para buddhi. We come to the buddhi. Buddhi is the seat of discrimination and wisdom. Now what is the discrimination? Discrimination is what is right and wrong. For understanding the right and wrong, we have to change our standpoint. See? That is all. Simply change your standpoint. Right and wrong will disappear from your life. See? It is not difficult, my friends. Whenever there is a fight between the two, the fight is only he is not able to understand her standpoint and she is not able to understand his standpoint. Change the standpoint. Like, you know, example, mother-in-law, daughter-in-law. Now what the mother-in-law is telling, she is not able to understand the standpoint of the daughter-in-law. And what the daughter-in-law is telling, she is not able to understand the standpoint of the mother-in-law. About this example I'll give you. This happened in Delhi. That girl's marriage was over and very nice, love marriage. Both of them were CA, chartered accountants, and doing good. Normally, mother-in-law, daughter-in-law, jagra started. So, she talked to her father. And the father said, "Beta, don't worry, we are behind you." And then he called me, "Swami, this is happening." I told her this thing. I said, "You are done wrong. Don't give her false, guidance. Now she is to live in that house. Ask her to talk to me." So she called me. I said, "Hey, how are the things?" So I said, "Look here. What is your age?" I said, "Tell truth." "I am 26. Very good. What is the age of your, I said, "Your mother-in-law's age must be in mid or late 40s. "Oh, Swamiji, from Bombay, you know what is happening in Delhi?" I said, "Don't ask questions, reply." "Yes, she is 48. I said, "Now remember, when the ladies cross 40, mid-40s, their hormonal balance becomes completely upset. They are unable to understand, think, and control themselves. It is a manufacturer's defect." Then, what is to be done? I told her in Hindi, "Usko bewakoof banao." How to do? Do whatever you have to do, but go on praising her. "Mama, mama, I thought I will come to a mother-in-law's place, but you are better than my mother." गधे को ऊपर चढ़ाने में टाइम नहीं लगता. एंड गेट द थिंग्स फॉर हर. "मम्मी मम्मी, आई वोंट कॉल यू सासु माँ, ओके मम्मी." स्लोली स्लोली एवरीथिंग क्वाइटेड. देन शी आस्क्ड, "स्वामी जी, व्हाट वाज दैट टेक्निक?" आई से, "लुक हियर, द टेक्निक इज दिस. शी इज अनेबल टू हैंडल हर सेल्फ, सो शी हैज टू ब्रिंग इट आउट समवेयर. देयर फॉर द डॉटर इन लॉ इज फ्रीली अवेलेबल. So you should understand this." After 2-3 years, everything cooled down. Then again I said, "Hey, how is the Dharma Kshetra, Kuru Kshetra?" "Swamiji, she is taking care of my kids. Now I don't have to worry about them. I can do my work." Free babysitting. But at that time, if you don't understand the standpoint of others, you will end up in a mess in life. So what is wrong expectations? If we want to correct them, understand the standpoint of the other person. See, friends, so these two things we have to conquer. One is desires for the worldly things. And second is expectation from any relation in this world. Two things. Your mind will stop reacting in life. And then you will be at peace with yourself. When you are at peace with yourself, you have conquered the mind and gone into the buddhi. See? Which buddhi? Buddhir atma mahan paraha. You go beyond the individual I and merge with the total I. Individual I is, I am the daughter-in-law. Total I is, I am one of the members of this family. See how simple it is? And when there are two, there will be some cut-cut. It is natural. See? The day we understand this, that our life is not only this much, expand yourself. So buddhir atma mahan paraha. Now to understand this, in our yoga vasishtha, I told you this thing. See? We all go through dreams. And in our dream, there are so many good and bad people. There are trees, mountains, animals, good thing, bad thing. Everything is there. After the dream is over, do we ever bother what happened to those people who were in my dream? Don't bother. Over. If this is clear, we are all in the dream of Hiranyagarbha. We are all in the dream of Brahmaji. Like we have this four-headed, mana, buddhi, chitta, ahankar. Brahmaji, also the same four heads. So like our sukshma deha, subtle body, creates the dream. And then when the dream is over, over. Forget about everything. In the same manner, our dream is at a different time scale. Brahmaji's dream is at a different time scale. Ours is a, every day we wake up from the sleep, it is a mini pralay. When Brahmaji wakes up from his sleep, it is a maxi pralay. Both are the same. And therefore, when we thus grow out of the individuality and come at the totality, our perceptions will be different. We'll not get lost in small little things. There was a couple, Mr. and Mrs. Gupta. And they never fought in their life. So that town decided to honor the most peaceful, happy couple of the century. They decided to honor. So all the people came in the municipal hall to honor reception. They came. And Gupta, Gupti and other people were standing, sitting there. And then they say, Guptaji, please tell, what is the secret of your life? You never fought. What is the secret? Tell. He looked at his wife. Meaning, should I talk? He said, okay. Husband and wife, they have got, you know, the drift in, not a normal language, abnormal language. Then he said, our secret is very simple. She decides about certain things, I decide about certain things. She decides about our family. What should be done, who should be called, who should be thrown, what should be purchased, what should not be purchased, what should be given, everything she decides. Then, Guptaji, what you decide? I decide whether America should bombard China or not. That I decide. See? How small, stupid things people fight. Therefore, widen yourself. and how to avoid. In this world, there is not a single person who does not have problems. This is another important principle, learn it. Body has to have diseases. If the body doesn't have disease, it is a dead body. If you have got pain here, pain there, congratulate abhijinda hai yaar, still alive. See? Similarly, mind. Mind will have all aberrations because mind is still alive. So be attentive. When all the diseases cease to happen to the body, body dies. But is really the body dying? Death is an impossibility. After studying Vedanta, if you talk about death, you have studied nothing in life. Last life, this life, next life, all bluffs. See, friends. So when the body dies, exactly what happens? The five elements go back. Who died? Our misery is like Vijay Mallya. We have taken so much of loan. When the question of returning it back, we feel miserable, run away. Our body is on loan. We have taken loan from the five great elements. So when you return them, who dies? Hey, Maharaj. Vedanta study is different and practice is different. Giving lecture is the simplest thing in Vedanta. The simplest thing in the whole world is Vedanta. See? So when the body dies, nothing happens to the body. Body goes back. Come to the mind. When the mind dies, what happens? Mind is what? We should know that. Mind is consciousness expressing is mind. What is light? Electricity expressing is light. In electricity, there is no light. In consciousness, there is no mind. Now, what is the difference between the mind and the consciousness? Both of them are knowledge. But mind is the knowledge where objectivity is predominant. And consciousness is the knowledge where objectivity is absent. See? When objectivity is dropped, you cannot have any thought. Thought-free mind is consciousness. Indriyebhya parayartha arthebhyascha param manaha manasastu para buddhi buddher atma mahan paraha. So from the individuality we merge in the totality. See? How simple it is. Then mahataha paramavyaktam. See? Mahataha paramavyaktam. See, beyond Hiranyagarbha is avyakta, the maya, the paramatma, the divine power, whatever word you give. Now what is this maya or avyakta or the avyakta nami paramesha shakti? What is that? That is the freedom. Okay. What is freedom? Fire has got the burning power, but the burning power cannot burn the fire. Sugar cane has got the sweetness, but the sweetness doesn't create diabetes for the sugar cane. See? So this whole world is the play of Maya. But what happens? We get caught up in this Maya. Like, take example, water, because of its avidya or maya shakti, is expressing as ocean. Then ocean expresses as waves. So, When our attention is only on the waves, the ocean is covered. When attention is on the ocean, the water is covered. When the waves break, nothing happens to the ocean. When the waves are born, nothing is added to the ocean. See, friends, and in the deep ocean, the water doesn't become sunk. It is remaining the same. Meaning, ocean is the cause, waves are the effect. Water is beyond cause and effect. This is the meaning. Purushanna param kinchit. If you really want to abide in yourself, try this. Give up cause and effect from your head. Have we ever asked this question, why the fire is hot? We never ask. We accept it. And thereafter, we deal. How to tackle this fire? Not only that, but how to utilize this burning ability of the fire to our benefit. See? Then you will be remaining in this world, yet beyond this world, like the water is in the ocean and in the waves. But waves are born, water doesn't born. And when they die, nothing happens to water. This technique is followed by intelligent children. Husband and wife always on war front. And the child knows very well. If the child wants something from the father, she will go and talk to father. Dad, I always feel sometimes sorry for you. What happened, honey, darling, what happened? See, you are so intelligent. How come you got married to this lady? She's always nagging you and all that. This is what that husband wanted. Nobody talks to him like this thing. Anyway, beta, we have to continue. What can be done? By the way, what you want? Dad, I want a new phone. Okay, I'll get you. What she has done? See, bevkoof banaya. All Mahatmas make us bevkoof. If you do this thing, you will go to heaven. Neither he has gone nor you will go. See, friends. If you are happy now, you have learnt everything. Be happy only today. That's it. How many days are in a year? Only today. So, a year of one day, can't you be happy one day in your life? And then let that one day be today. That's all. Purushanna param kinchit. So you have reached the destination. Purusha means be attentive. The one who started the journey, Purishayanat Purushaha. The one who wanted to achieve something, whatever name you give him, soul or whatever. So he started. I want to realize. And first of all, done all kinds of rubbish. Yoga, running here and there, and going from here to there, walking, so that I can realize God. Hare Ram Ram. Difficulty on the traffic. See? Therefore, the one who wants to realize, he started his journey with this understanding, and then started as a Purusha, and ended as a Purusha. Started as a husband and culminated as a man. Oh, I was unnecessarily miserable for so many years. See, who was miserable? The husband who never existed. See? So, the seeker starts the journey. He is the jiva, the seeker. The paramarthic jiva started the journey. And where he ends up? Purnatvat Purushaha. He comes to discover the ultimate, what I was seeking was none other than me. I was lost in these appearances of illusions. As mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, rich, poor, Indian, non-Indian. In this, we are fragmented into pieces. Come back. And thereafter, play the game of life. Na kuch pana, na kuch khona. Wherever, whenever, whatever you are, be 100%. But don't become serious Karnataka. That's all. Purushanna param kinchit and sa kashtha sa paragati. This is the ultimate in our life. Here, those nihilist, Buddhist, they say, see, he said, Purushanna param kinchit. There is nothing. Nothing doesn't mean there is nothing. Other than Purusha, there is nothing. And that is what? Sa kashta, parakashta, sa gatihi. That is our destination. And this we experience every day. When we are in deep sleep or when we are in nirvikalpa samadhi. Friends, every one of us goes through nirvikalpa samadhi every day, dozens of times. But we don't recognize that. Sometime you get up at night and look outside and there is full moon. That is nirvikalpa samadhi. But we don't recognize. This nirvikalpa samadhi is indicated in this Upanishad only. Ashcharyavat pashyati kashchidenam. Ashcharyavat vadati tathaiva chanyah. Ashcharya means what? That experience which does not fall in the category of cause and effect. If somebody is absolutely real, not real, absolutely punctual, never, never late. If one day that person comes late, Ashcharya, hey, how come you are late today? Ashcharya, that is nirvikalpa samadhi. Therefore, go beyond cause and effect. Why? Cause is, the sky is too high. My friends. And once you take this stand, then in every experience you can discover the truth. For example, it is all said in Bhagavad Gita. For example, we recognize the things in this world in two ways. Is and is not. See? This is a black color. This is not a white color. Everything is and is not. And both of them are known by me. So I support existence of the things. I support the absence of the things. So I am supporting both presence and absence. Then who am I? I am supporting both. Therefore, I am beyond presence and absence. And that is why we never have the experience of our absence. These few techniques which I told you, reflect on that. Not for telling others. This is one of the difficulty when they listen to Vedanta. Whenever the food is not digested, it comes out as a ulti. And when the food is digested, assimilated, it doesn't come out as a ulti. If this Vedantic knowledge is digested, you will remain silent. Come, I'll tell you. You know, five elements, 1, 2, 3, 4. There are five. Tape recorder. Work on yourself. So, this simple thing. Everything is recognized by us in two ways, is and is not. Now apply. Do we have an option that I am not? No option. Option means vikalpa. If we do not have option of our absence, is it necessary to say that I am? This is Nirvikalpa Samadhi. You are seeing me, you are hearing me, but seer and hearer is not born. That experience where there is no vikalpa is Nirvikalpa Samadhi. But we create vikalpa. But why it is so cold? Why it is very hot? Samsara begins. Therefore, one of the spiritual practice will be give zero choice to yourself. When you don't give choice to yourself, means what? We don't complain about anything. Will the space complain? Will your toilet mein rakh diya? No, everything is in me. See? Therefore, purushanna param kinchit sa kashtha sa paragatihi. If we grasp this principle properly, you will never talk about that when I was sitting for meditation, light came and it went away. Or when I was sitting, then fragrance came. Aha. Thumb rule. Any experience which comes and goes is the trick of the mind. That experience which never began, which never modified, which never ended, is the truth. Purushanna param kinchit sa kashta sa paragatihi. Therefore, it is so easy, friends. We don't have to struggle. Whenever we struggle, we are going the wrong way. See? What is the natural way for the water to flow from higher to lower level? But if we want to take the water at a higher level, then you have to struggle, put a pump. If you are swimming in the river, if you swim along the current of the waters, no struggle. But if you want to swim across or against the current, you will be suffering. Now apply this principle. Many people keep on talking on politics. You are talking on illusions. See? Government is an illusion. Or you get lost in that. Aaye the Hari Bhajan ko, hotan lage kapas. Now, this truth is to be discovered by oneself. The teacher continues further. Esha sarveshu bhuteshu. गूढ़ोत्मान प्रकाशते दृश्यते त्वग्रया बुद्ध्या सूक्ष्मया सूक्ष्मदर्शिभिः एष दिस परम पुरुष पुरुषान्न परम काष्ठा सा काष्ठा सा परागति सो दिस एष पुरुषः सर्वेषु भूतेषु It is not only for the seekers of the truth. No. There is but one reality. This is another important point we have to catch. Earth is one, water is one, fire is one, air is one, space is one, mind is one. Minds are not many. One space, we put the walls and it becomes 2 BHK. One mind occupied with one body becomes Mr. Ego. After body identification, then the illusion of inside and outside becomes valid. Now we will say we are inside the hall, or slippers are outside the hall. Then slippers are inside the temple, car is outside the hall. Then the car is outside the temple. Then car is inside Bombay and Delhi is outside Bombay. In, out, you require some reference point. And what is the reference point? We have body identification. In deep sleep, there is no reference point. And therefore, tatra mata amata bhavati, pita apita bhavati. In deep sleep, we are no more mother, father, brother, sister. And therefore, we are happy. So where from the whole thing starts? Starts only after body identification. Therefore, there are not many souls. This is what happens in karma kanda, in yoga, in so-called devotion. All the time talking about this life, next life, going to hell, going to heaven. Send them to hell. You don't go. This is called technically tatparya nirnaya. We must know the moral of the story, why this is told. So the purpose is, we must stop blaming the world for anything that happens in our life. First step in spiritual practice. See? And when we stop blaming the world, but we go through good and bad experiences, then we start inquiring, why this is happening to me? Then we go to the palmist. Panditji, dekho na jana, what happened? I am not getting married. Okay? Keep 500 rupees first. You cannot get married. Why? Akhanda Ananda Yoga. How simple it is. Slowly, slowly, you start discovering the things. Then we go to satsang. And when you go to satsang, we are told there, look here. In the last life, you have done something wrong to her. Therefore, in this life, she is your wife and she is taking revenge. But I don't remember. It doesn't matter. But now what can be done? Behave properly with her, or in the next life, again she will be your wife. No, no, no. Don't cut such jokes. Behave properly with her. Net result, you will stop complaining about her. And when you stop complaining, when you are at peace with yourself, this is what Upanishad says. Drushyate tu agraya buddhya sukshmaya sukshma darshibihi. When you are no more reacting in life, then you start thinking and inquiring. When you react, you complain. See, my friends. Therefore, esha sarveshu bhuteshu gudhotma na prakashate. Like there is only one space, one air, etc. There is one reality. It is not one per body. Therefore, these so-called soul, go to Goa, make a soul curry and enjoy. Don't get frightened by going to hell and heaven. See, those who frighten us to go to hell and heaven, you tell them that we'll see you there. See, friends, Nayamatma Balahinena Labhyaha. Unless you have got some intentions, you will not tell all those lies. So, Esha Sarveshu Bhuteshu Gudotmana Prakashate. But this divinity is not able to manifest. We are not able to recognize this divinity. Then what should be done? Drushyate tu agraya buddhya. Drushyate tu sukshmaya buddhya. Drushyate tu sukshma darshibihi. Three things. So, drushyate tu agraya buddhya. Ekagra. Ekagra doesn't mean making single point. That dumb thing which is done in yoga, tratak, don't do that. If you want to get a headache, you do it. Remember, concentration keeps you in prakriti. Awareness brings you out of prakriti. See? Otherwise, concentration, those who do that tratak, they'll be keeping something in front. See? You must have seen the eyes. Two examples I give. I think morning also I gave these two examples. See the eyes of Bhagwan Ramana Maharshi. There is a depth in his eyes. They are at peace. Second thing, you see Osho. Tantric people, you see their eyes. Don't feel comfortable in their presence. It's not only them, you must have come across. There are some people, they are not bad. But at least this is my experience. At certain people, I cannot see, I cannot look eye to eye. As if they bounce on you. Strong personalities. Therefore, drishyate agraya buddhya. So what is the ekagra buddhi? Ekagra buddhi is you are committed only to spiritual life. All other things can wait. Na kuch pana, na kuch khona. Nothing to do, nowhere to go. But then you keep on running around the world. Time pass. First principle, time pass. Before somebody has to tell us, yahan se jaane ka kitna lete hai Mahatma ji, you should leave. Our Shastra very clearly tell, chare veti. Stagnated water rots. Moving waters always fresh. You know what happens? Devi Sureshwari Bhagavati Gange, you are so great. Gangaji thought, oh, because of me, so many people are benefited, so many towns and villages are benefited, therefore, I will now stop running and I will be here. So, Gangaji stopped the flow. Within few months, the Ganges water started rotting. So, what is the destination? Ekagra. Destination is, human form is only to make it such a fit instrument through which the divine can express in full glory. Okay? So what is the destination for the Ganges? Ganga Sagar. Cows are kept for milk. Cow dung and gomutra, byproduct. In the same manner, if some people are benefited by our presence, it is a cow dung and gomutra. Don't get carried away by that. But this is what happens. And then, like it happened in Bidar in Karnataka, there was one retired Air Force officer. He told me, Swamiji, do you see that hillock? I said, yes. On that, there is one tree. I said, that I can see. Why don't you construct an ashram there? I said, no, I don't have money. No, I'll give you money. I said, then you construct. No, but why don't you come? I said, I'm not interested. No, you don't have to do anything. I will construct everything I will do. Then, so whenever we want, we can come and take your darshan. I said, why don't you tell me you want a free chowkidar? But why don't you start some schools? See? I said, you are making me talk which you will not like. No, tell. Bacche tum paida karo. School mein chalao. Phir bewakoof ho gaya. Friends, the only purpose of our life is he expresses through us. And what is that expression? Samoham sarva bhuteshu. Name dveshosti na priyaha. Chatro mitre putre bandhav makuru yatnam vigraha sandham. How important it is, friends. Therefore, drushyate tu agraya buddhya. So agraya means what? Don't forget the purpose of our being human beings. Nothing else. Then, sukshmaya buddhya. And for that, our thinking should be sukshma. What is the sukshma? Every experience will become our spiritual examination. And in that examination, we have to pass. We cannot fail. That is sukshmaya buddhya. Every experience is only for our evolution, nothing else. Like you must have seen in the good gardens, they have pruning, cutting, and giving shape so that it looks beautiful. In the same manner, to bring out the divinity out of us, the divine out of sheer love for us, goes on pruning, cutting, honor, insult, success, failure. Then slowly, chinnam chinnam punarapi punaha, svadu chayvekshudandam, dagdam dagdam punarapi punaha, kanchanam kantavarnam. See, friends. Therefore, every experience of our life is only for our evolution. If you take this stand, then it is sukshmaya buddhya. Sukshmadarshibihi. Then they are no more influenced or attracted towards this gross world. They are discovered the substratum of all the illusions. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.